We talked a lot about cinematic and realistic renders in Blender on my channel, but everyone knows that rendering animation requires a lot of time and resources of computer, especially if we're talking about realism and realistic render. Now I explain you how you can create some kind of static animation in Blender without spending days or weeks waiting for a render. I have two cinematic animations, one with a moving camera and this one with static camera. This way would be better fit for the static camera when you have some moving elements or animation in the scene, but the camera stays on the point. This Blender scene I've created as a part of my masterclass. If you wanna learn more about how to make this from scratch to amazing result, creating atmospheric light, learning how to use megascans to create realistic environment, and wanna know more about how to create cinematic animation in Blender, I made masterclass for you, where I will show you how I created this and guide you from start to final result. For more information and how to get this masterclass, use the link in the description. So, let's take a closer look at this animation that we are going to create. As we can see, there are only leaves moving and the water has some animation waves. Another part of the frame static. What does it give to us? I can do one render frame of the scene and render moving parts separately from the main render. Then I can combine everything in compositing. If it sounds complicated, don't be afraid. We need just to find out how to make renders separately. And Blender has everything to do this easily. We can use collections in a Blender and separate them using view layers. As we can see, now I have only one view layer in my scene. I can turn on interactive render to see everything in this view layer. I'm going to use 5K image for the final render and we will see how it will change the time of rendering using this way. But before rendering, let's name this view layer main layer and copy this view layer to create a new one but with settings from this layer. As we can see, now we have a new view layer with all collections from the first one. I call this layer leaves. So going to the main layer and I'm going to turn off the collection with flying leaves and I'm going to do render without leaves here. In this case, the render time is 13 minutes and 37 seconds. It's a pretty huge render time for animation because if I do render animation with this render time for each frame, I have to spend almost 50 hours waiting for a final result. I don't have so much time to wait. So I'm going to compositing and I have to save this clean render without all the color gradient and effects which I already have here. I'm going to save this as EXR multi-layer because I need also to save CryptoMate render layer. It's important because we will need masks to combine everything properly. So, save this render as a basic render and now we can change the view layer to leaves, where I want to render only of leaves collection, but I need all scene and light setup where I want to do render only of leaves collection, but I need all scene and light setup impact to this layer as this leaves rendering in the same scene, not like a standalone collection. In this layer I have to select indirect only. As we can see, now we have additional option of each collection. If I select indirect only in the collection, that means we will not see this collection on the render, but they also will be impacted by render. I select all collections except leaves. I turn indirect to render to show you it more clearly. Now we can see only leaves. Just need to choose transparent in the render settings. See how it works. I do test render. As a result, 27 seconds per frame. It's good. I go to compositing and duplicate this one just to choose here another view layer related to leaves. Good. Also in this scene I have water with animated waves. That means I need to make a view layer for this water surface. I copy this view layer, name it water. I select leaves as indirect and deselect water. Due to water has reflection, we can clearly see how indirect only works. On the render, I have a water surface, but the whole scene is impact on the surface. As we can see here, all reflections that we had on the first render were rendered as full scene. Let's do the test render to see how much time it will take. So, it took 2 minutes and 10 seconds. Much better than 13 minutes per frame. Okay, I'm going to compositing mode and duplicate this one. Change the water layer and connect it to the viewer to see how it works. Alright, we have one render with full scene and separate renders with water and leaves layers. I need to save all these layers. For basic render, I just save as usual image render, just choosing EXR multi-layer to save all render layers and deselect this for render. I don't need to render this one more time. But for another two layer, I have to save the image sequence. To do this, I need a file output node. Duplicate this, connect this one and this one. I doubt that I will need these render layers, so I am going to save only render and can use the PNG sequence. Finally, I have to check that all necessary layers are chosen for rendering in the render layer. Leaves used for render. Water used for render. Okay, important for animation rendering to turn on persistent data. In this case, all data for rendering is kept in memory after rendering and will not be uploaded again for each frame. It also saves a lot of time, especially if you have long time animation. So, press render animation and wait for the final result. So, for you it's one transition and we are in a new Blender file, which I'm going to use for compositing. I have all the necessary render layers and it's time to combine everything into one amazing animation. To do this, I need the mix node and connect the water sequence. Change mix to add. But as we can see, this is not correct, because other scene objects like leaves and lanterns crossed with the water surface. That is why we need CryptoMate. We need a mask to select only the water surface and combine it with the main render. Add CryptoMate node. Change to image and select our basic render with CryptoMate layers. If I connect it with viewer, CryptoMate looks like this. Colored image. But CryptoMate saves a lot of information about all objects in the scene. That is why I just select CryptoMate object and pick water surface. We have a mask for the water surface and can use this as a factor in mix node. And now everything is correct. Good, let's do the same for leaves. Mix node, connect with main compositing line and connect leaves layer. Also change to add mode. As we can see now, everything on the right places. For the more correct way, I have to place leaves behind this branch. I can use CryptoMate again, pick this branch and use as a mask. But I need to invert this one for the correct result. So, this is what my compositing setup looks like. Everything on the right places, leaves animated, water the same. In my general scene, we could see that I had some color gradient and effects set up in compositing. I need to transfer everything to this compositing file. It's pretty simple, I just select all nodes and select Ctrl-G to make a group node. Press Tab, name and save this file. Now in this scene I do append and find my general Blender file. Open this one and I need node trees. Here we can see this color correction node. Select this node and now I can press Ctrl A to find this node. Ungroup and as we can see all nodes transferred successfully. So I connect it to the main compositing line. As we can see, this way can help to save a lot of time. Just render all animated elements as separate layers and combine everything into one image in compositing. Finally, I wanna do some small color grading and adjustment in DaVinci Resolve. This is also free software that has powerful tool for color grading. Here I wanna just highlight the central part of the animation and make the foreground darker. Exaggerate a little bit of fog line and make color grading. Write in the comments below if it's interesting to get some tutorials about DaVinci Resolve and you wanna learn more. Again, I remind you about my masterclass. If you wanna learn more about cinematic animation in Blender, all links in the description. Subscribe to my channel, Instagram, Patreon, and I'll see you in the next video.